Now, for the next presentation, I would like to call Dr. Tahir Kamal. He is an assistant professor at Lahore General Hospital, and his topic is use of intralesional 5-fluoroeresyl in the treatment of warts.
Assalamu alaikum, respected chairperson, co-chairperson, respected colleague. I am Dr. Tahir Kamal, assistant professor at dermatology department, Lahore General Hospital. And my talk today is on efficacy and safety of intralesional 5-fluoroeresyl in treatment of warts. As we know, warts are a common problem, and these are the benign proliferations of skin and mucosa caused by human papilloma virus, which are of different types. And warts have variable clinical presentations depending on the site and size of the warts. Coming on to my topic, if we discuss different treatment modalities, we broadly classify into topical, ablative therapy, intralesional, and systemic therapies. But we must consider three things which we dermatologists come across usually in the treatment of warts and becomes a challenge. Number one is the higher recurrence rate, especially with some topical treatments and duration of the treatment. Secondly is the cosmetic outcome, and it might lead to scarring. So that is also a concern, and especially in case of genital warts. And thirdly is the intralesional variety, where cost effectiveness can come into action, or the systemic side effects also. So these are the main factors which we come across these common problems like warts, especially in case of genital warts. And systemic therapy as well, but with variable response, so we have our reservation in these therapies. Previous studies have shown effectiveness for intralesional 5-fluoroeresyl. So just a brief word about 5-fluoroeresyl. As we know, it is anti-metabolite and anti-neoplastic action. So it basically acts on thymidine dilate synthesis enzyme, which is obviously acting against the DNA virus. And finally, it has an anti-proliferative action on active proliferating cells. So theoretically, and it does make sense to help in the treatment of warts which are caused by human papilloma viruses, and they are DNA viruses. Objective of my study: to determine the efficacy and safety of intralesional 5-fluoroeresyl in the treatment of common warts. Methodology: the study was conducted at Department of Dermatology, Lahore General Hospital, and duration of the study was 8 months. The sample size was 40 patients finally, and the sampling technique was non-probability convenience, and it was interventional therapeutic trial. Inclusion criteria included age between 10 and 60 years of age, warts more than 3 months duration, and warts were not treated for more than 2 months. In the past 2 months, they were not treated for any treatment. Exclusion criteria excluded, it was carefully excluded, age less than 10 years of age, past history of allergy and asthma in the patient, pregnant and lactating mothers, diabetic patient or immunosuppressed patient, and history of bleeding diathesis, and finally, patients with vascular disease or involvement of any renal problem or with chronic liver disease or any liver derangement or derangement in the liver enzymes. procedure. After written informed consent taken and ethical clearance obtained from relevant authorities, 44 patients were enrolled according to the protocol, and 4 of the patients left because of the non-compliance. 40 patients completed the trial, and with minimum of 2 sessions, if they got response in 2 sessions, they were out of the study. I mean, they got 100% clearance, and maximally as a protocol, there were 6 treatments. So after making it aseptic with isopropyl alcohol and area was sterilized, the warts were injected intralesionally with 0.1 ml of per centimeter square. So this is an important point. The area was given the priority. It was injected area-wise per centimeter square of 5-fluorouracil, which has a concentration of 50 milligram per ml at the base of every 0.1 centimeter at the base of the wart. Procedure was repeated every 2 weeks, and patients were finally evaluated 3 months after the last treatment. Photographs were taken at each session and at the time of the follow-up, the final follow-up visit.